his spirit never die. Come on! Hey, 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 hey!
Yes. Welcome to Spain, Roland Grappo.
Yeah,
nice. We are from TNT Radio Rock. And I had a little questions for you.
Mm-hmm.
Well, you are now in Master Plan.
Long time already.
Long time, yes. 13 years.
Yeah.
13 years. Bueno, dice que ha estado en Master Plan los últimos 13 años. Vale. 14. Before this, you were in Halloween.
Mm-hmm.
Long time too. 12 years.
More than 12, yeah.
More than 12 years. Well, now you have a new live DVD.
Mm-hmm.
The first, I think, in your career.
Yeah, it's the first one. I mean, I did one. It was Halloween, of course. High Life. Mm-hmm. And for Master Plan is also the first one, and even it took a long time. We had a plan long time ago as well, that also with the first lineup after the first album, but always the record label said, no, we don't need it now, it's too early. But we recorded material already on the first tour with Master Plan, I remember. It wasn't a headlining tour.
Wait a minute. Dice que es el primer DVD que graba con Master Plan, que grabó uno antes con Halloween, que es High Life. Pero con Master Plan, después del primer disco, plantearon grabar un DVD, pero no lo veían la necesidad, y ahora es cuando han decidido hacerlo.
Yeah, and we recorded already on the first tour with we supported Hammerfall at that time, and they made also video, and we used the same camera team and paid some little money to record it, but we never used it, so it's still in my studio somehow hidden, and maybe later, maybe 10 years.
No. Dice que hicieron una gira conjunta con Hammerfall, ellos de hecho pasaron por España el año pasado y que usaron el mismo equipo de vídeo para grabar el vídeo de Hammerfall, el suyo, que le salió bastante barato y después se mezcló en su estudio. Well, how is running the disc now? Do you sell it well?
I'm not really sure. I didn't ask for. I think a live DVD is never a really big selling. Except maybe in the 70s or 60s, you know, when my favorite band Grandpa made a live album. I think it was one of the biggest highlights, you know. But nowadays it's just information for the fans. It's not about selling so much, it's about, I think, more advertising the band, because still a lot of people didn't see us live. And when they buy or see a video of us, professional made with a good sound, not YouTube stuff, you know, I don't like it so much when people's filming. It's maybe interesting from the view, it looks good from the fan, but the sound is always terrible because it's a small camera recording with one signal on one guy in the band, and it's always not the right position, so it's always too loud or distorted, you know. And now we wanted something professional to show the people that we have some good playing and good kind of chemistry with the fans.
Bueno, dice que en general él no sabe cómo se está vendiendo, que tendría que preguntarlo, pero que en general los DVDs no se suelen vender muy bien. Lo que pasa es que esta es la primera vez que han hecho ellos un DVD profesionalmente, que habían hecho antes con cámaras de aficionados o con videocámara, que tenían mal sonido siempre, que no era lo que tenía que ser, y que ahora realmente con equipo profesional dan una visión de lo que es la banda en directo. Keep Your Dream Alive have a lot of songs of your first album,
mm-hmm.
and just four of Novum Initium. Why did you choose this set?
I think it's just a natural thing, because that's the same like Iron Maiden or other famous bands like Halloween. They play also a lot of old stuff, because the best sales were in the beginning of our career, like first, second album. Then the business was a bit changing and everything, and a lot of fans writing me, I love the first album. Then some others say, my favorite is the second album, you know. And it's, of course, I have to agree or admit I have the same feeling. So it was our strongest work so far. We develop, we change our, you know, kind of taste a little bit. But we still want to make some strong albums in the future, and maybe going a little bit back to the album style, on the first or second album. No. More powerful.
Bueno, dice que en general los primeros álbumes son los que tienen más éxito, los que los fans piden más, y que haciendo caso un poco a lo que los fans le han pedido, han incluido más canciones de los primeros discos, que de hecho su favorito es el segundo, aunque haya más canciones del primero, yo coincido, mi favorito también es el segundo, y bueno, que a partir de ahora van a hacer más discos y van a hacer muy buenas canciones y que por lo tanto tendrán tiempo de coger los sets y cambiarlos. Well, today you begin 10 days tour in Spain. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. What can we expect from Masterplan on this tour?
I think it's just the natural thing, you know. It's like we want to play, having fun with the fans together. That, like I said, we want to present our live DVD in a way of promoting the band, being in this country and showing that we are presenting ourselves here and I always loved to play in Spain, you know. It was always one of the highlights of my career. It was Halloween, was Masterplan as well, and it's always good to come back here and to make people happy, and in the same way the fans make us happy. So it's a good chemistry.
Dice que van a que la gira es para presentar su disco en directo, Keep Your Dream Alive, que básicamente van a hacer esto, pero que para él siempre es un placer tocar en España, que hay muy buena audiencia, que están muy contentos, que tienen muy buena química con los fans de aquí, y que la intención es pasarlo bien, divertirse y hacer divertir a quien vaya a verlos. Your tour set will be basically Keep Your Dream Alive, or do you change anything?
We changed a couple of things because when we made the video recording, it was already 3 years ago, to be honest. I look totally different. Much better now.
Dice que sí, que van a cambiar un montón de cosas, porque cuando grabaron el disco hace 2 años, y que ahora han cambiado un poco las cosas.
Because we had a very new lineup when we recorded, especially this part of the show of Masters of Rock in the Czech Republic. And we played hardly just 1.5 hour. Now we have 15 minutes longer. We changed a couple of songs, we have some difference, and we play now I'm Not Afraid from the second album, with Wounds.
Dice que esto se grabó en Czech Republic, República Checa, okay, mm-hmm. En el Masters of Rock, que con la formación nueva, que evidentemente van a cambiar ciertas cosas, que van a tocar del segundo álbum, ¿what song? ¿Dice usted?
Now we play Wounds and I'm Not Afraid. And
from I'm Not Afraid, the second album.
And from Halloween we play The Chance. It's kind of surprise for the fans. Not anymore, I said it. But it's nice to get. Because now we're recording also the songs I wrote for Halloween with Masterplan soon. We started already.
Dice que van a tocar también The Change, de Halloween, que eso es una sorpresa, realmente sí que es una sorpresa, porque tiene el proyecto de grabar un disco con Masterplan haciendo canciones de Halloween. Bueno, Sacramento will open 5 shows for Masterplan. Manuel Escudero was singing Heroes with you last mm-hmm. year, last summer. Could we see any surprises like this? Manuel singing with you?
Why not? Why not? No, it's like nice to have some special guests, you know, especially when they're anyway here and helping us to make a song rocking and with the fans together. I think it was a lot of fun, and yeah, we might do it again if he wants. I didn't see him so far, so we will see.
Dice que por qué no, que sorpresas como esta realmente están bien, que tener estrellas invitadas como Manuel siempre es divertido, y que por qué no, que si él quiere, evidentemente se puede volver a hacer. I think if I aren't wrong, it is your first time touring Spain like headliners, a tour in Spain.
Not sure. We did a headlining tour 3 years ago. I think we did 2 shows, maybe. If I'm right, I'm not 100% sure. We did so many shows.
Dice que no está seguro porque ha hecho muchos shows en España. What do you think about the Spanish audience? Do you like play here, I suppose?
I think it's just it's hard to say, it may be stupid because you think it's advertising my point of view, but I grew up in Germany and Spain was always a part of my, you know, dream to live here or to make holiday here, and I was so many times here, I have so many friends here, so it's something special, you know. And when we play, it's always good kind of audience and good singing and performing.
Dice que ellos crecieron en Alemania, pero que España forma parte de su backup también. Que ellos han venido mucho a España, que le encanta venir aquí de vacaciones, que le encanta tocar aquí, que tiene muchos amigos en España y que bueno, que siempre le da mucha fuerza.
Also on Halloween we stayed so many times here in Spain. You know, we did videos here, we did album recording on Tenerife, and so I feel kind of home here, to be honest.
Dice que con Halloween estuvieron muchas veces tocando aquí, que realmente grababan los discos en Tenerife y que es como su segundo hogar. Okay. You are a reputedly producer too in the metal world. What projects do you have now?
Projects, in the moment I just started something fresh, an old legendary band from Czech Republic, which is was really famous in the 80s, and they made a comeback now, and I was mixing one song some months ago, and they were so happy about my work, so I have to continue with them for the next CD. And they like me so much, they want also that I being part of the live shows, so maybe I'm a special guest on the live shows, and they do many shows, it's just one country or two countries.
Legend is it?
Yeah, called Citron, like citrus.
Citrus.
Yeah, Citrus.
Dice que va a grabar otro CD para una banda de la República Checa, que son leyenda en Chequia, que se llaman Citrus, y que posiblemente también esté tocando con ellos en directo en un par de países.
And they want me also that I play some songs with them, and but I also want to sing. So in the future I want to sing a little bit more, and maybe I'm a special guest singing.
You sing too?
Yeah, of course. I grew up playing guitar and singing at the same time.
Nos dice que va a hacer unos cuantos shows con ellos y que también le vamos a poder ver cantando con esta banda, que él también canta y que le apetece hacerlo como invitado especial.
And besides this band, I do many, many trash and rock bands, metal bands in my studio. And I'm proud to be part of the Spanish band Lords of Black. I did also some, I think, two albums with Sacramento.
Oh, Kilmara.
Kilmara as well. And what's the other famous band? Yeah.
Ago?
But Lords of Black, I did the second album already. Yeah. And Tony Hernando is one of my good friends. And I'm really happy that the singer of Lords of Black is now with Richie Blackmore. And I was helping them to make a sound. I'm really proud of it.
Sí, dice que él ha producido álbumes también para bandas españolas, como Lords of Black. Está muy contento porque ha producido el segundo álbum de Lords of Black, que va a ser un muy buen álbum. Está muy contento porque Ronnie Romero ahora estará con Richie Blackmore, con Rainbow, haciendo los shows, que es un gran amigo de Tony Hernando, el cual comparto con él, con lo cual está muy orgulloso. También ha producido el disco de Kilmara, Love Songs and Another Nightmares, ¿vale? Que también está orgulloso de esto. Está muy orgulloso de tener un estudio y de poder producir para las bandas. You was, or are, I don't know, in another band, part of Masterplan, Sirius Black.
Yeah, I'm still wearing the...
Are you in Sirius Black? Or not?
No, I'm not in the band officially. So we don't have any problems. I just told them I don't have time enough, you know. I had the idea to maybe play in two bands and to, you know, being happy more in the way of being more creative or also financial. To be honest, many, many people have to play now in two bands, you know, to survive because the business is very hard. But then I realized it's not possible because they started touring and I was clashing with the tour dates of Masterplan, and I decided just, you know, Masterplan is my main band. But maybe on the second album I'll play guitar again for them, you know, just for helping. Friends.
Dice que ya no está oficialmente en Sirius Black porque le era muy difícil compatibilizar las dos bandas. Su banda principal es Masterplan, había giras que chocaban las fechas de Sirius Black con las de Masterplan y que no le es posible mantener las dos bandas, pero que tiene buena relación con ellos y que posiblemente en el segundo disco toque la guitarra también con Sirius Black para ayudarlos. Well, what are the future of Masterplan? I think, and you told me before, you have in mind a record with Halloween songs.
Yes.
What songs do you include?
We choose 12 songs, that means 10 songs on the album, two bonus tracks or something.
But your songs?
My favorite, you know. I wrote a couple of more songs of in Halloween, but my favorites are around 10, I would say. It starts from The Chant, Mankind, Someone's Crying from the first album. Maybe Music, I Don't Wanna Cry No More from the second, Chameleon. Then from the third, Masters of Rings.
Wait a minute. Bueno, dice que él lo que va a hacer en este disco es poner sus canciones favoritas de Halloween, que va a poner del primer álbum Mankind, del primer álbum, que va a poner también del segundo álbum. What song of the second album?
Second album, I think Music.
Music.
I Don't Wanna Cry No More.
I Don't Wanna Cry No More.
And another one.
Después que también va
Three songs I have there.
Va a incluir The Masters of the Ring. Masters of the Ring él estuvo en Halloween.
Masters of the Ring es Mr. Ego and
Mr. Ego, really.
Mm-hmm.
It's one of my favorites.
Yeah, thanks. And there was another one, Still We Go.
Va a poner Mr. Ego de Master of the Rings, Here We Go.
And the bonus track we do for Master of the Rings, Take Me Home.
It's like take Me Home como bonus track.
Yeah. So from the next album, I just wrote one song, but it's Time of the Oath.
Strong.
From Time of the Oath, I wrote just one song.
The Time of the Oath, solo una canción. What song is?
Time of the Oath.
Time of the Oath. Like the title. Mr. Torture is included?
No, Mr. Torture is not for me. And Dark Ride, I wrote two songs, Escalation 666 and The Dark Ride. Mm.
So. The Dark Ride va a hacer Escalation 666, Escalation 666. Y The Dark Ride, la que da título al disco.
Yeah.
Well, I think it will be a very good record.
Yeah, and I forgot one song. There's another bonus track.
And new material for Masterplan? When can we hear?
We just started last year already. We had a session when we played on the festival in Murcia. We stayed a couple of days in a hotel and we started songwriting, and everybody's making some songs at home. But we still continue after this Halloween recordings, which we finish maybe in 1 month. So then we continue with songwriting for the next studio album, which comes out 2017. So the Halloween album comes out on Halloween 2016.
Dice que ya tiene canciones compuestas para el próximo álbum de Masterplan, que empezó a hacerlo el año pasado, pero que ahora se han metido de lleno en el proyecto de las canciones de Halloween, que calcula que sobre un mes van a terminar de grabarlas para que el disco salga el día de Halloween de este año, es decir, el 1 de noviembre de 2016, y que el próximo álbum de Masterplan seguramente saldrá en 2017. Ok. Bueno. Throughout your career, you worked with very good singers.
Oh yeah, which
Michael Kiske, yeah. Andy Deris, John Lande, Rick Alsi.
I'm really proud to work with really one of the best singers, to be honest. Yeah. Also on solo album, Mike Vescara. No, yeah.
Dice que para él son unos de los mejores cantantes. Por ahí va mi pregunta. What are the differences with each of them? With who do you work better, or do you have more affinity?
It's hard to say, because everybody has his strengths and has weakness. I mean, the singer is something very personal, you know. A singer has his voice, and it comes out from inside. He can't change it. The voice of a singer is always a question of taste, you know. Every fan has a different opinion about it. And I love Andy Deris, I love Michael Kiske a lot. But they're totally different in a way, you know. But they play in the same band, you know, Halloween. And but Jorn Lande is someone maybe I have to say he's incredible, great on records. But live I prefer to work with Mikey Kiske the most and with Andy Deris, because they make good action on stage. You know, I like more the whole, how you say, concept of a stage performance. Especially when you play live, of course, and I love when you have party with the fans. And I think Andy Deris is great frontman, and Mikey Kiske as well. I mean, in the beginning, Mikey was 19 or 20 years old, and he was fucking good, you know. I was always proud to be Hector.
Nos dice que son distintos, que claro, no se puede comparar uno con otro porque las voces son distintas, de hecho las composiciones fueron para cada uno de ellos, pero que sí que le parece que Jorn Land en disco es estupendo, queda muy bien, pero que en directo prefiere Michael Kiske, porque Michael Kiske da mucha fuerza en el directo y como ellos son una banda de directo, de hecho estuvieron en Helloween cuando Michael tenía 20 años, 19, él tocaba la guitarra y Michael cantaba, y realmente era impresionante, y que la fuerza que da Michael en directo le parece mucho mejor que los demás. Rick Alsing.
Yeah, so that's what I want to continue. So of course in the studio or on albums I loved Jorn most, maybe I have to say, because he's a really good songwriter and his melodies are great. And I think Rick is something between Andy Darris and Jorn. So he's a great frontman, he's a good, great singer, which is similar to Jorn. And I think with Rick is in the moment the best solution we have, you know, because we need someone who's believing in the band, supporting the band, and he loves to be band member, and he likes to play live with us, he loves our songs, and he's really happy, and we are happy to have him.
Dice que continuando con lo que decía, Jorn le parecía muy bueno en estudio, pero que Rick Alsi es un gran sustituto para Jorn, tiene una voz que estaría en medio de la de Andy Darris y de la de Jorn, que en directo es un grandísimo frontman, que eso realmente lo certifico porque lo he visto en directo, es muy bueno, y que como ellos son una banda de directo, necesitaban a alguien que en directo diera fuerza, que además creyera en la banda, que estuviera con ellos y que trabajara a fondo con ellos, y que Rick es la mejor opción en este aspecto. Ok, bueno. With Helloween, you recorded High Life, or part of High Life, in Girona.
Oh yeah,
in Spain.
Girona, yeah.
I was in it, Joe.
Yeah?
I was laughing with you. Do you remember anything of the show in Girona?
Girona, yeah, I think it was the main part, isn't it?
Yeah, because the first song in the record, Andy Davis, Hello
no,
Girona.
Yeah, I know. No, of course I remember. It was a beautiful show and some special moments. Still, sometimes I'm watching one or two songs on YouTube and fans, you know, sending it on Facebook or something. And I didn't see the whole show for a long time, but I have great memories.
Sí, dice que sí, que recuerda el concierto, que recuerda haber visto algunos vídeos en YouTube de los fans disfrutando y que le parece un muy buen show.
It's just 20 years ago.
De 20 años.
Oh,
younger than now. Éramos más jóvenes los dos. Yo también estuve allí. Well, do you want to talk anything to the fans who come to see your Spanish tour and for the people who are undecided now? Because this interview is published tomorrow.
Okay. Yeah, I'm really skeptical in the moment about the music scene and about everything. You know, you never know. I was a bit frustrated at the beginning of the year that everybody's, you know, not everybody, but many famous people died. You know, like Lemmy, David Bowie, and many more. You know, but I was really depressed and I felt like, well, maybe I'm also getting into the age. Yeah, I never know how long we're gonna tour. You know. In the moment, we have many plans for the next 2-3 years. That's why. Come to the show. You never know how long Master Plan is playing live. You know, we still do a lot of albums, maybe. But
bueno, hablando un poco de todos los grandes leyendas de la música que han muerto, como Lemmy, como David Bowie, que al final no sabemos si mañana vamos a estar aquí, que él tiene planes para Master Plan para los próximos 3 años, de volver a España en gira. Pero que vengáis y que veáis lo que hace Masterplan en directo, que si no lo habéis visto nunca, yo sí los he visto y realmente son una banda espectacular y hacen unos shows fenomenales. Vale la pena venir a verlos. Well, we're finished. Thanks for your time, Roland. It was a pleasure to be with you. And I wish you all the success in Spain.
Thank you very much.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you.